Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.
Okay, today I want to speak to you about marriage. You know, a few things that married people also don't say, specifically maybe men, okay? And the reason I want to bring up this topic is because there are some of these young unmarried members in my group who keep asking questions about marriage. So I'm too busy, I don't respond, I see the messages. But anyway, so here are a few things about marriage that married people do not say, some of the ugly truths about marriage, okay? Now I'm not going to just tell you the most obvious. The most obvious is extramarital affairs. I mean, everyone knows about this. Okay, she had or he had an extramarital affair. Fine, okay. That is a story that everyone likes to say or incident. There's something greater than that. Even worse than an extramarital affair is having someone cheat you. Cheat you in terms of money. Now, you don't normally hear these stories because it's not very common. But here in these third world countries, there are so many guys, mostly foreigners, you know, they are 50, 60 year old. They get married to a 20, 30 year old and they think, oh, wow, you know, this girl who's small, who looks petite, who looks beautiful. Oh, she loves me, my fat belly and my hairy, ugly personality. And in his home country, nobody even looks at him. He's a bum. But here he comes, oh, you're so nice. So he thinks he has found a gem. Only one day to realize, by hook or by crook, she took all his money. And this is not a aloof incident. Huh? This happens very, very frequently. Very frequently. The wallet, the money has been taken out. From the bank account, money has been just taken out without the guy knowing. I mean, you have to put your guard up 24/7. You know, to be a person who cannot be fooled. But the chances of it happening, you know, okay. Let's move on to something even more common that nobody talks about. Here's a big one. This even I'm going through. Okay? Honest reality. Let's say you get married. And after you get married, the person's perfect. Say my wife. Perfect. Everything nice. Are you aware of the fact that you can never be alone after that? Now, what do I mean by alone? You'll never get your privacy. You'll never get your space. Now, lucky for me, my wife being younger than me, 15 years, she gives me plenty of space. She doesn't disturb me. She's an amazing gem of a human being. But I'm talking of privacy as in you wake up in the morning, there's nobody in your house. You can go to your kitchen, and the way you cleaned it yesterday night remains the same way. It's sparkling. You make your coffee, you clean the coffee cup, it's still sparkling, you know, it's that smell of cleanliness is there. Then you sit in the veranda and you sip your coffee and there's no noise. You'll never get that. For those of you who... Oh, wait, another Harley Davidson. Okay, for those of you who have never experienced it, it's something you must experience to understand. Go to a 5-star hotel. I'll just tell you, go to a 5-star hotel. Or forget 5-star, go to a 3-star hotel. And be a guest over there. The silence, you know, the silence. The sound, the smell, the cleanliness, the service. You'll feel like a king. Nobody will be there to disturb you. You can take your laptop, do your work. It's so beautiful, man. I'll tell you, you'll never have that in your life again. I can keep the house perfectly clean, go to sleep. When I get up, my daughter has made a fucking fiasco out of everything. If you see my videos, why do you think the house is a mess? Because no matter what I do, no matter what I do, my daughter will destroy it. I can keep everything clean. She'll make the floor dirty. If the floor is spared, the walls are made dirty. If the walls are not, if the walls are spared, she'll make the bookshelf, she'll throw stuff. Anything you can't think of, she will think of it. She'll either smear food everywhere, or she'll throw juice, or she'll take the soap, she'll open up packets. You know, sometimes even the baby, when she wants to go to the toilet, now she knows, okay, if she has to go pee, she will tell the mother. Sometimes she doesn't tell the mother, she goes pees, and she doesn't wash herself properly because she's just a 2-year-old baby, you know, 2.5. And then imagine walking around all over with pee. And forget that, the noise. You know, sometimes you just want to have quiet. You know, like when you watch those videos of the Bose sound cancellation, it feels amazing. You'll never ever get that. In your sleep, you'll not get it, because maybe the baby woke up. When you want to work quietly with the customer, you'll not get it. Maybe when you're in your creative zone, there's an interruption. I mean, what do you do? You can tell your wife and kid, okay, go to the mall or for 1 hour. Maybe you can tell them that. I'm not talking of 1 hour, man. So this one is a major thing. And I'll tell you why. I'm being honest with you, which I've told my wife. And I know some friends of mine who have actually done it. I really wish my wife and my kid would go back to the village for a month, 2 months. I just want to be left alone. I want to experience the world alone, just quiet. Myself, I'm not saying this so that I can sleep around with other girls, that I can do it even now. It's very easy. You just go to one of the massage parlors here and she'll give you a nice massage, and she'll, you know, if you negotiate with her, she'll agree to have sex also. I'm not talking about that, man. You will really miss this. Then, apart from this, the next one. Let's say you got married to a girl, you're in love with her. She is amazing, she's beautiful, she's sweet, she's whatever. Now, remember what I told you, you are in love. Now, what happens when you fall out of love? Do you think this can happen? You fell in love, you're in love with the girl. What if you fall out of love? You don't think this can happen? Let's say, for example, you liked a particular chocolate or pizza or food. As a human being, we tend to like things, and then after some time, we get bored of it, right? Your iPhone, your car, even maybe my YouTube channel, a person, an individual, we get bored of things. It can be a coffee shop, it can be anything. So you think this doesn't apply to a human being, relationships? So what do you do when you're out of love? This is something I've actually seen people, a guy, man and woman, both, who fell in love, but at some point they realize, no, it's, we were in love, we are not anymore in love. But you know why they remain? Because now children is there, it's inconvenient, it's so much of a headache, so they don't want to rock the boat. Now, last if not the least, final one, okay? Like, remember, I've not stated about anything extreme like extramarital affairs, or, you know, I just said about Okay. Cheating money. Okay, those are all extreme. Let's assume those are extreme. Okay. What if the person you married turned out to be a mistake? Serious question. What if the person you married turned out to be a mistake? Do you know how many divorces take place? Just ask a divorce lawyer. Ask a priest who does annulment. I've been through 3 divorces. Just ask them how many people come through their door to ask a divorce or annulment. How many? You know, the chances of realizing it is a mistake is so high. 2 people can be madly in love as lovers, boyfriend, girlfriend. Marriage is a whole different kind of relationship, man. That is why so many boyfriend, girlfriend, best friends, they realize marriage was not for me, man. If you personally ask me, today when I look back, marriage has made me a better human being, has made me a better guy, okay? I'll be honest with you. It has made me a better person. Are there challenges? Oh, you better believe it. And I'm not talking just money. Money is the... For me, fortunately, money is a small detail. The bigger one is the adjustments, the privacy, the peace of mind. You may not understand, but you can ask a married guy if you're not married. A baby screaming and shouting in the house, making the house a mess and not giving you space. And I mean, you can literally look at the baby angry and shout, and after 1 minute, the baby will come back and again want to play with you or make your room a mess or do the same stupidity again. Like my friend, he told me, he has 2 daughters. He wants to do work. They're shouting, screaming, throwing things around. So he goes, he shouts at them, he gives them on their bottom. They both start crying and he comes back to his room. Half an hour later, they are at it again. The same nonsense. So he says, he's saying, then I think, what the fuck do I do now? Go and beat them harder? I know one guy who has literally taken up a project in some other country and purposely, insisted on being there only. The owner has given him the option, you have to come back home, no problem. He said, no, I'll be here only. It's not that his marriage is a mistake, it's just that he wants peace of mind, yeah. See, overall, let me just tell you, what you see in the movies, now this marriage and this beautiful and groom and bride dressed up so elegant and loving photographs, and this is only showbiz. It's only one moment captured. Just imagine if life was a movie, this is one frame. It's not the entire movie, man. I miss my privacy. I miss my freedom. I miss just being alone, And this is not to say that I hate them or something. Just that you'll miss it. You'll never get it. You'll not understand if you're not... I've not experienced it. That is why so many men and women, so many, they choose to be single. They're happy being single. They don't want to complicate life. Anyway, this is what I wanted to share with you guys. Let me know your thoughts. What do you think? Think I'm right? Do you think I'm wrong? I'd love to hear your thoughts. Okay? You guys take care. That's me signing off. Chal. See you in the Harley guy. Harley Davidson. Okay, you guys take care.
Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.